What's up guys, hope you're doing great. This is your boy Kobe Shots. In today's video, I'm going to show you how I use just one light to light up a night scene for a film. But the backstory is very interesting, so stick and stay through to the very end. Let's get right into it. So following up to this particular video is going to be a documentary about how I filmed the entire first feature film ever in my career doing filmmaking. And in this particular documentary, I'm going to share with you everything that ensued, together with remarks and submissions from the actors and the crew. This very cinematic sequence that you're seeing right now wasn't part of the plan initially. The whole idea behind the film Room 406, which again this video is going to have a follow-up of the documentary about it, was supposed to be a short film, but we added scenes like this particular sequence to give the story more flesh and more suspense. So my friend over here, who's Mali, a wonderful friend of mine, photographer, filmmaker as well, who has helped me on countless occasions on my YouTube videos here on my channel, also aided me as well as part of the crew, doubling up as a cast. Yet, interestingly, his face wasn't shown, as you could see in the sequence. We had to camp at his end to edit the film. And in that process, we just had an idea that how about we create a sequence that's very cinematic that can introduce the film to the audience to arouse their feelings. So basically, we're looking at using what we know in lighting. So as a director of the film, I decided to create something that will be thought-provoking, suspenseful, and as well give you that visual appeal that you might want to start your film with. So when that idea happened, I decided to do this in the night. And in the night, of course, you need some lights. We had an available light source that was coming from the building's veranda. But of course, ceiling lights are not always the best. It doesn't have a very good color rendition index. So we needed to avoid it as much as we could. And in that process, we needed to plant a light. And for a night scene, the light that's going to be obviously available aside some lights from a household would be the moon. The moon itself is not a light source. It's just a reflected light that is bounced back towards the earth. So in the case of a full moon, you realize that the night is lit more, that you can even actually see better in the dark. And in filmmaking, as daylight has warm tones, nightfall has blue tones. And so with the use of an RGB light, that's the Ambitful FL80 RGB, I switched the light to a blue tone to mimic the moon and used a warm light, which is a practical light, which is in the form of a lantern used by the subject to create more separation of the color from the subject to the background, as well as everything that you see in the scene. And to my camera setup, it's very basic. I needed some smooth camera movement. And for that matter, I resorted to a gimbal. I used the Zhiyun Crane 3S, stabilizing the shots from the Blackmagic Pocket Cinema Camera 6K Pro with the Sigma 18-35mm as the lens. I use this particular lens because it's very fast, 1.8 of an aperture, and this aided me to amass enough light in the dark. So I took some shots with camera movements, revealing the scene first of all, then to the prop held by the character, concealing the face of the character, the identity of the character. And I did this because the main goal was to create suspense in the very first sequence, which is this particular sequence for the full movie itself. After revealing my character with the lantern, I took some shots following him up to his destination, which was a table. So he sets the lantern on a table against a box, which is lit, always reflecting the blue light. And because the box is covered in a wrapper turned or flipped to the other side, it reflects the light back more, giving the whole visual appeal much more sense and separation, because it's going to catch the blue light, which is from the Ambitful, shot through a light modifier, which is a simulation of light being bounced off the surface of the moon towards the earth. So this is how simple we went ahead with the processes to create this wonderful sequence. Again, on the recap of the light sources, I had just two light sources, which firstly is Ambitful FL80 RGB, shooting through a softbox, as well as a lantern, which is a practical light, given two different tones, tungsten and daylight tones. The setup, I would say, took a little bit more time because we're experimenting with how the scene was going to be lit, looking at what the camera was shooting and adjusting accordingly. And in the end, I think we spent barely an hour and a half to finish this scene. And I love it. Anyone I showed it to also loved how it looked. So it was a successful scene, and I look forward to making more and even better ones. Thank you very much for watching this video to the very end. If this was informative and educational to you, don't be selfish. Share it across all social media platforms. And don't forget to subscribe if you are a newcomer over here. That's what we do over here. We share and we learn. Thank you very much once again. Turn on the post notification button. I'm going to catch you next time in the next video. Have a wonderful day. See ya.